our channel Be Always Learner. Today, in this session, we are going to understand the classification of signal, which is the important part of the signal and system. The signals are classified according to their characteristics. The first type of classification is going to consider the continuous time signal and discrete time signal. This is the representation of continuous time signal XT. X is dependent on the time index T, and in discrete domain X is represented as a discrete time signal which is depending upon the function n. Now in the graphical representation, this is the representation for the continuous domain. The signal is continuously varying. Signal is continuously varying with respect to time. And in case of discrete time signal, you can just see the signal is having instantaneous values. That value at 0 is something, value at 2 is something, that is represented by the spikes, and in between these values we are not having any kind of information. We are having the values on the right side also, and we may have the value on the left side also. The next type of signal classification is deterministic signal classification. A deterministic signal is a signal exhibiting no uncertainty of values at any given instant of time. It means if we can represent XT, which is a continuous time signal, and it is equal to say A of sine omega T. If this is the representation, then we can know the value of X at any instant of time. So it means any signal which can be represented mathematically, mathematically that signal is called to be as a deterministic signal. And that signal, if it is this kind of signal, so it is again continuous by nature, so we can also represent by the sine wave that we are having. The T component is there and X component is on the Y axis. In the random signal, a random signal is a signal characterized by uncertainty before it actual occurs. Means we are not aware of the exact value of the signal at any given instant of time. That may vary anywhere at any instant of time. We are not able to predict the value at any instant of time. It is also represented by XT in continuous domain. Another kind of representation is periodic and aperiodic signal. The periodic signal is represented by XT plus capital T. The capital T is nothing but the fundamental period. The fundamental period of a signal, through which we can determine the periodicity of the signal. And this equation is sustained for all the value of time in case of continuous domain. In case of discrete domain, this equation is modified by xn is equal to xn plus capital N for all the values of capital N. And the smaller value of n in this holds is known as fundamental period. And the unit of omega, we can also consider here that XT is equal to A of sine omega naught T plus theta. This is a signal where omega naught is expressed in radian per second. So it is a frequency, and theta is the phase, which is expressed in radian, and A is the amplitude. By definition, we know that XT is equal to XT plus capital T, that we know. So from this equation we can have that XT plus t. We can calculate. We can put the value t is equal to t plus capital T. So that will be a of sine, that is omega naught t plus capital T, that is equal to, sorry, that is plus theta, and we can further write it a of sine, that is pi naught t plus omega naught capital T plus theta. Now if I am going to compare these two signals, this one, this signal, this equation and this equation, we are having, after comparing, that omega t naught is equal to 2 pi, right? And if it is so, we know that t is equal to 2 pi by pi naught. It means the signal is periodic when this equation is going to persist there, and where t is the fundamental period and omega naught is also the fundamental frequency. Now in another case, for exponential signal, we can represent that xt is equal to e raised to the power j omega naught t. So this is for exponential signal. We know that xt, for the periodicity, xt is equal to x t plus capital T. If it is so, then we can write x t plus capital T is equal to, by this equation, e raised to the power j omega naught, that t is equal to t plus capital T, and it is equal to e raised to the power j of omega naught into t plus omega naught into capital T. This is equal to this. Now if I am going to equating this equation with this set of equation, then because of periodicity, then we'll have that e raised to the power j of omega naught, sorry, e raised to the power omega naught t into j is equal to 1. To sustain this equation, you very well know that omega t should be equal to 2 pi. Then t is equal to 2 pi by omega naught. This is true for the exponential signals also. Using these two equations, this is the first equation and this is for the exponentials equation, we know we can calculate the fundamental period t for the different numerical problems you will have in your syllabi. Another kind of representation or the classification of signal is even and odd signal. A continuous time signal is said to be even if it satisfies the equation x minus t is equal to xt for all the values of t. This symbol is for all the values of t. So this is for even signals. Now for odd signals, a continuous time signal is said to be odd if it is going to satisfy the equation x minus t is equal to minus of xt. For all t, right? So any signal xt, composition of even component plus odd component into a given signal. Now it is the basic equation to find out the relation between even signal or even component of the signal, between the signal, we have to replace t by minus t in this equation, and we'll have the modified equation x minus t is equal to x e minus t plus x o t minus t. So this is the combination of these two, and we are going to just represent it x e minus t here from this equation and from this equation. We are landed with x minus t is equal to, because it is even component is equal to xt, so it is xt plus, it is x minus t for odd component, so it is x o t. So this is the kind of representation we are having. This is for the even one and this is for the odd one, right? So adding the equation, we are having adding this equation, say it is A equation and it is B equation. Adding the equation A and B, we are landed with xt plus x minus t is equal to x e t plus x o t and plus x e t or minus x naught t. So these two are added, so it is landed with the 2 x e t, and this is cancel out, so we are having x t plus x of minus t, and we can represent as 1 by 2 of x t xt plus x minus t is equal to xe. If this stands for, if you know the signal, we can calculate the even component of the signal. In the same way, if we can operate A and B, we can just subtract A minus B, we'll have x t, this one x t minus x minus t is equal to x e t plus x zero t minus with x e t minus x zero t and bracket close. We'll have x e t plus x o t minus with minus of x e t and plus x o t. Now this and this cancel out. We are landed with the term x t minus x minus t, and these two are added up. This is landed with the 2 x o t, and this is equal to x o t is equal to x t minus x minus t, and we are having 1 by 2 here. So this is the equation when we are going to know the signal and we have to calculate the odd component of the signal. So these are the sections which are more important for the numerical section side. Now this is also true for discrete time signal also. The discrete time signal that we know for the representation of even signal, x minus n is equal to xn. For all the value of n. This is for even component or even signal, and for odd one we are having that x minus n is equal to minus of x n for all the values of n. So that is by definition, and we can also calculate as we did in the continuous domain x e n. If you want to calculate in the same pattern, we can write 1 by 2 of x n plus x minus n. And for odd component, x o n is equal to 1 by 2 x of n minus of x minus n. So for the discrete domain, these kind of representation can be worked out. Another type of classification is energy and power signal. So for energy and power signal, so we have to consider that if we going to apply certain voltage to a resistor, that is can be represent, this is a resistor, and we are applying certain voltage V to a resistor R, there is a flowing current I. To understand it, this kind of circuit can work out. So we can calculate the power. PT is equal to VT into IT. So that is the power we are having. We can represent the I by V by R. V again is a function of time. We can rewrite is V square by R. Now in another case, we can also represent the power, which is function of time, is equal to I square function of time into R. Now for a resistance R is equal to 1 ohm, we can write these equations like PT is equal to V square function of time, and PT is equal to I square. These equations shows that the power is equal to the square of the amplitude of any signal. Now to calculate the energy for the interval, there interval T is less than and equal to capital T, that is integration from minus infinity to infinity for entire interval. We are going to calculate as per the integration rule, and we have to put limit T tends to infinity for infinite signal. And we can also calculate the power is equal to limit minus T to T I square T dt. Now to calculate the power, we have to divide with entire interval of time, and again we have to put the limit T tends to infinity. So this is for a system which is defined by this figure. Now for generalized way, we can calculate the energy, which is equal to limit capital T tends to infinity integration minus T to T xt dt. And generalized form of calculating power is limit T tends to infinity, again the divided by the total interval of the signal, that is minus T to plus T xt dt. So this is the way we are calculating the power of a signal. Now this is for the continuous domain. For discrete domain, we are not using integration there because the signals are discrete by nature. So here the energy can be calculated by xn square of this summation n is equal to minus infinity to infinity. This is the method to calculate the energy. And the average power we are going to calculate here, the limit capital N tends to infinity, the total time is 2n plus 1. Why it is 2n plus 1? Because we are considering the length of the signal from minus n to capital N, but in between there is a zero also. So for this, it is for this zero we have to consider 1 here. Now summation n is equal to minus n to capital N x n mod of this n square. So this is for calculating the average power. A signal is called an energy signal if the energy is finite and P is zero. And for power signal, the power is finite and energy is equal to infinity. So this is by definition we know the energy and power signal. And what is the method to calculate the energy, average power of a continuous time domain signal and discrete time domain signal? The last classification of the signal is causal and non-causal signals. This is quite simple, that continuous time signal xt is said to be causal, if xt is equal to 0 for t is less than 0. Otherwise, the signal is non-causal, right? If it is anti-causal, then xt is equal to 0 for t is greater than 0. So similarly, we can define for a discrete time domain, this is causal and this is anti-causal or non-causal. So for discrete time domain, xn, we are going to represent xn is equal to 0 when n is less than 0, and xn is equal to 0 when n is greater than 0. So this is the basic definition of causal and non-causal signals. In the coming session, we are going to cover number of numericals related to these signal classifications. Hope you like the concept. And please share and subscribe the channel so that we can do the more effort to make you understand about the concepts.